Is that a... Okay. Great. Thank you, everyone, for being here today to listen to me talk about the post-divorce program, which is essentially just an informative guide to how to get through your divorce without losing your mind. And we're going to talk about three important points here. Number one is these things happen. The first part of going through a divorce is being able to cope with your feelings of going through a divorce, and also handle your children. Number two is conflict in custody, keeping the kids in the picture without keeping them inside your fights. And then number three, and the most important thing, is communication and family time, and why it's important to keep the family together, even though mom and dad aren't together. Now, part one, these things happen. We live in the U.S. where half of all married couples get divorced. Not only that, but 24% of people are living in their second marriage. In Tennessee, it's 31%. And I put a graph up for you. And these figures, which are 2015, 14, and 13, show that roughly 2.2 million people got married in 2015, and roughly 800,000 people got divorced. And these figures are basically the same for the past 15 years. Anywhere between 2 to 2.3 million people get married every year, and anywhere between 800 and 950,000 people get divorced every year. And these are figures that I got from the CDC. So what does this mean for you? It doesn't mean that you're failing. Just because you're getting a divorce, that doesn't put you in the bottom 50% of people who get married, because these things just happen. And it's something that we need to cope with. And one of the things that I'm going to reference is Brene Brown's book, The Gifts of Perfection. And whether you're getting a divorce or not getting a divorce, this is a wonderful book to get. Brene Brown, who is not just a public speaker, who had a TED Talk, she's also a professor at the University of Houston Graduate College School of Social Work. And she has several books out. One of the biggest topics that she talks about is shame and vulnerability and how to handle yourself without sucking the life out of everybody else in the room. And a couple of really important quotes that I thought we could reference here was imperfection in child rearing. One of the biggest points that she makes throughout her book, The Gifts of Imperfection, is that cruelty is easy, cheap, and rampant. And this is one of those things that we have to fight ourselves with when it comes to divorce. It's really easy to try to just take the kids and walk away. It's really easy to do things to lash out in the middle of divorce. It's really, really hard to cooperate with someone when you have these very, very big feelings towards them, especially when those feelings are negative. And Brene Brown talks about that both in her book and in a couple of her TED Talks. Which brings me to part two, conflict in custody. Now, in the U.S., typically, when parents get divorced, mothers get custody, right? Well, it's 2017 now, and that's actually changing. We're seeing more and more fathers getting custody of their children, and more parents who are having 50-50 custody, which is something that Mary S. Whiteside proposed in her article written in the Journal of Marital and Family Therapy. Now, she was a leading therapist before she retired at the Ann Arbor Center for Family Therapy. And one of the things that she proposed was that the ideal divorce involves 50-50 custody of the children. That's the parents switching the children back and forth peacefully, and this keeps the parents able to both have a good relationship with the children, which is extremely important because the most important thing in a divorce is your children. If you ask my stepkids who they'd rather live with, they both say that they'd rather live with both their mom and their dad. Actually, Allie proposed that her mom and her dad move back in together,
and that I am her mom's fiance moving together. It's the perfect plan, it just didn't work.
And two really important things that we need to remember during a divorce is, number one, don't insult the mother. Women can do a lot more than just child care and home care. And don't insult the father either, because fathers can do child care and home care. My child is 5 months old, I will never be a girl mom. Her dad is that. Which brings me to the Thomas Kilman Conflict Resolution Scale. Now, Kenneth Thomas and Ralph Kilman are doctors of behavioral scientists, and they are the founders of the Thomas Kilman Conflict Media Instrument, or the TKI. And what they proposed with it is that there are 5 typical resolutions to conflict that we use. We use compromise, competition, avoidance, accommodation, and collaboration. And we're going to discuss the 3 most effective scales of conflict resolution in the middle of the divorce. And those 3 most effective are going to be collaboration, compromise, and accommodation. Collaboration is going to be your most ideal. Now, we all understand that the most ideal divorce doesn't happen, because the most ideal divorce, well, doesn't exist. But when they reference collaboration, this is when everybody wins. This is your general 50-50 custody agreement. This is mom and dad getting together to have family dinner nights, and mom and dad never having issues with each other. Collaborating with each other doesn't necessarily mean you're going to have conflict. Collaborating with each other just means that you guys are going to be able to figure out a way for both of you to have what you need. Compromise is a little bit there. Compromise means sacrifice. So when you're compromising in your divorce, as far as custody goes, offer a babysitter. Ask the parent to babysit. Don't spend your money on a babysitter when you don't need to. Work around each other's schedules. And remember the golden rule, which is treat others the way you want to be treated. This is especially important in divorce. It's really easy for a person to get angry and not want to compromise with another person. And Brene Brown's book, Gifts of Imperfection, is definitely helpful with addressing your shame and addressing those feelings that you're having. It is okay to seek counseling when you're getting a divorce. A lot of people don't, but it is okay to do that. The next point, the last one, is accommodation. Accommodation means that somebody's giving up a little bit willingly. But it's okay to accommodate each other. This means go ahead and offer a babysit and say yes to finding your children anytime that you can. And understand each other's boundaries and respect them. If mom or dad doesn't want you calling after a certain hour, don't call after a certain hour. Figure it out together. Which brings me to my last point, and the most important point, is time together. Mary F. Whiteside, in her article in the Journal of Marital and Family Therapy, talks about parents collaborating when it comes to your divorce. And one of the most important things to remember is that mom and dad don't actually have to be together to spend time together. So birthdays and holidays absolutely can be spent together. I have a friend who does family dinner nights every month with her ex-husband. They all get together at mother's house with all of the children, and they have dinner together. They discuss the issues that they're having with the kids. They talk to the kids about each other's issues. Because spending time together as a family doesn't necessarily mean that you guys have to be together. And yes, that means let mom bring his girlfriend. Let dad bring his girlfriend. Let each other have their separate spouses, because eventually, there's a 1 in 4 chance that they'll be married anyway. And most importantly, keep the
management within a divorce can be a really, really touchy subject when it comes to the kids. And like I said, it's really easy to just box yourself in with your children and never let anybody else in. So a really important thing to remember when you're getting a divorce is you were in love with that person once. You were married to that person. You had to collaborate, you had to compromise, you had to accommodate your schedules, just like they had to accommodate yours. If we remember those really, really important, even if they seem really tiny issues, it's a divorce. These things happen. You can get through it. Just talk about that. Have it. That's it.